Hey guys, today we're talking about the four organizing styles and I'm going to answer your most frequently asked questions. First, I'm going to break down the four styles. Here's the thing. Organization is not one size fits all. All the things you find in stores or you see on TV, they're generally one style. But if you've struggled and felt messy or you're tidying something up and it seems to get messy again right away, it's probably because you organize differently. So I love saying to people, you're not messy, you just organize differently. And I'm gonna make the four styles really simple. Basically, there are visual people and there are hidden organizers. If you're a visual organizer, for you, it's out of sight, out of mind. You love to see your stuff. If you're a hidden organizer, you would prefer to have those everyday items out of sight. You like visual simplicity. And the other side of the four styles is if you're a micro thinker or a macro thinker. And a micro thinker is a detail-oriented person. They are planners. And a macro thinker is a big picture thinker. They're not really into small details. When it comes to organization, micro organizers, they love putting things in little categories. They'll stop and take the time to put things away in a detailed way. Whereas macro organizers, it's about fast, easy. They just want to toss because their mind has already moved on to something else. So let's jump right in and start with a B. A B is a visual organizer, so it's out of sight, out of mind. They love to have their everyday used items out where they can see them and they're easy to access so they don't forget about it. This is why open shelving, lots of hooks, pegboards, any type of visual organization is perfect for a B. A B is also a micro organizer, so they're very, very detailed. They tend to be perfectionists. They like things done in a certain way. And because doing micro organization is time consuming, maybe they're looking for the perfect product, they tend to procrastinate or put things off until they can do it properly. They also struggle with just indecision. What's the best way to organize? They research a lot, they plan, they overplan. And this is all part of that micro thinking and micro organization. Next, we have the complete opposite bug, which is a ladybug. Ladybugs are hidden organizers. They like everything to be out of sight. Some ladybugs, like myself, were a little extreme. We don't want to have any visual sort of clutter out at all to the detriment of us. We're also macro organizers, which means we need fast, simple, easy solutions. And when that isn't set up, we just shove and hide our stuff anywhere because our big picture goal is maybe a clean kitchen. So we'll just shove all the things in drawers and anywhere out of sight. It's for this macro tendency that drawer dividers, lots of bins and baskets, that's what's really going to help a ladybug stay organized. Big containers all over the place so they can hide their things out of sight, but in a really big macro way. Next, we have a cricket. A cricket is a traditional organizer. It's basically what all organizing products and all the things you see on TV basically are made for a cricket. Crickets are hidden organizers, so they prefer their things to be out of sight, but they're also micro organizers. And I feel like their tendency towards perfection definitely outweighs their need to have everything out of sight, which means if they do have bills that need to be paid or projects that have to be finished, a cricket will leave it out so they, like, as a reminder to do it, even though they're not visual bugs, they still want to put things away properly or finish something 100% before they put it away. So for this reason, sometimes it's hard to tell the difference between a bee and a cricket because they both can have neat piles everywhere, but a cricket really would prefer when everything's done, they're done with something, they're not gonna use it again, to have it out of sight. They're gonna take the time to put their papers behind closed doors or take the toaster off the counter and put it in the cabinet when they're done with it. Whereas a bee would rather have those everyday items out on the counter where they can access them. And last but not least, we have a butterfly. Butterflies and ladybugs are really similar in that they're macro, they're big picture thinkers. They are not gonna stop to file things in a detailed way or put something away if they have to open a lid, you know, to put, there's no, they're already moved on. It's not that they're lazy, it's just that macro thinkers don't think in details. They think of the end goal. The difference is that butterflies are visual organizers, so they don't want to hide everything away unless people are coming over. Then they'll put everything in baskets and boxes and hide because company's coming. But for them, they like seeing their everyday things because it's out of sight, out of mind. So they like having their papers out or the things they use all the time. They love seeing their items. And this combination of macro organization and visual organization tends to lead to a lot of mess, as you can imagine. They're leaving things as they go because they're not taking the time to put things away in a detailed way, and they're leaving things out because they want to see all their stuff. So butterflies, more than any other bug, definitely struggle with a lot of perceived clutter. Even though ladybugs also have messes in all of our hidden areas, butterflies tend to have messes in all the visual areas too. So when you know your organizing style, then you can set up a system and a home that really works for you. So let's jump into my most frequently asked questions. The first question I get asked all the time is, can I be a couple different bugs? Like, I'm not totally a ladybug and I'm a little bit of a cricket, and that's totally fine. I really want you, you can't put people into four categories. So I want you to look at this as a scale. For me, I'm 100% a ladybug, but some people may be partly a ladybug but have some cricket tendencies with their paperwork, or they may treat different areas of their homes differently. And so you don't have to put yourself in a box. You don't have to choose just one organizing style. But if you are struggling with an area to keep it tidy, or it's just not staying organized, or you just are feeling overwhelmed, it is a great tool for your toolbox to try to identify where your natural tendencies lie. Are you more visual? Are you more micro? And that can help you design a system that's going to lead to success. The next question I get asked all the time is, what do you do if you have two people or multiple people living in the same house with lots of different styles? So when it comes to compromising, the golden Clutterbug rule is you always lean towards the visual bug. And as a hidden organizer, I really hate this, but the truth is it's so much easier for a hidden bug to have more things out and visual, such as hooks instead of closets at the front door, or visual paper organizers, than it is to try to force a visual organizer to remember things out of sight. So we always compromise to the visual bug. And when it comes to micro and macro, we always compromise to the macro bug. It's just a lot easier to organize in big categories, especially even for crickets and bees, to have bigger categories like one for bills, instead of trying to get a macro organizer to file things like electricity and gas, and you're getting the idea. So always default to the visual and the macro organizer, which means if there's a butterfly in the house, they always win. And the last question I get asked all the time is, I need you to tell me exactly how to organize for my type, or show me exactly what I should do for my space. And unfortunately, that's not something I can really give you exactly how to organize. Everybody's space is different, your home is different, your stuff is different, but I definitely can offer some inspiration. I have four Pinterest boards, one for each bug, so one for a cricket, and I'm pinning lots of things that are inspiration for each of those different bugs so you can visually get some ideas. I also have a free online course, a mini course, all about the four different organizing styles, where I really go into detail about different products and solutions that work for each different bug. So I'm gonna put the link down below to that. There's also a free ebook that breaks down all of the different bugs. Again, I'm gonna put the link down below to the ebook and the free course and the Pinterest page, which offers lots of inspiration for each bug. And these are all free resources, so please check them out. I'll put that in the description below. Hey guys, thanks so much for those of you who have stayed to the end. So I have a story for you. I feel like I have to give you a little backstory first, because if I just tell you the story, you're gonna think I'm a weirdo. But I was not planning on having a third baby. It was definitely a surprise, and everyone knew it was a surprise because I was really emotional about it at first. Kind of had a little bit of a panic attack. We were not ready for a third baby. We had just moved into a 3-bedroom home. It's just, anyways, so my kids were very confused, Izzy and Abby. They were 6 and 4 at the time. Like, well, if you weren't planning on having a baby, how do babies happen, Mom? Like, where do babies come from? So my explanation about the birds and the bees was that the mommy has an egg and the daddy has a seed. And when the seed and the egg go together, they create a baby which grows in your tummy. And I think in Abby's brain, she put something together. Okay, so let's just move on with the story. We're at Great Wolf Lodge. I'm very pregnant, like with a huge pregnant belly. And two little girls were in the women's washroom, which is packed full of people. And I'm washing their hands and I'm trying to lift Abby up to wash her hands. And this really nice lady beside me is like, oh, you have your hands full and you're having a third. Is it a boy or a girl? And we were just having a conversation. And she was like, were you planning on having a boy? I was like, no, he was totally a surprise. And Abby pipes up, yeah, mommy didn't want a baby, but daddy just slipped it in there while she was sleeping. I kid you not, the bathroom went so quiet. And Abby knew she must have said something wrong, so then she just kept saying it again. Daddy slipped that baby in there while mommy was sleeping, but now mommy's happy that there's a baby in there. And everyone burst out laughing, and I'm totally bright red because, I mean, she meant the seed, and she assumed, I never said he slipped anything in while I was sleeping. She must have put that together because I was surprised I was pregnant, right? And she knew that the daddy had to give the seed in the mommy's belly somehow, and if I didn't know he was doing it, she put that together, that he did it while I was sound asleep. And so that's the story she told 40 strangers in a public bathroom. Hilarious and embarrassing, but that's it. So I thought I'd share it with you kids, right? Am I right? Anyways, I'll see you guys next time.